I'm in New York City and I'm shooting the cover for Men's Fitness magazine. It's interesting to be on the cover of Men's Fitness because it is a very much a physical magazine about, you know, about your body and how you train. And when you've been training for 20 years, it's like I know what I'm doing, but you never really know how your technique is. Are things as straight as they need to be, and are you bending over the right way? It's just weird to work out in front of a camera, which I've never done before. Of course I did it amazing and probably the best photo shoot in Men's Fitness history, but would you expect anything less?
Today's shoot was really about the things that someone can do to work on their cardio aspects of their workout. Basically everything without weights, and how to utilize a park and basically create a workout around the limit of facilities.
Men's Fitness is exactly what it says. It's about staying fit. It's more about endurance and about the physical aspect rather than just how much pounds you can put on, how big your arms are, how much you bench. That's why I think for me, it's almost a better fit to be in Men's Fitness because it's more of how I train anyways. So that's kind of what we're focusing on, a little bit more of the circuit training of what I do.
Working with Chris is great. He was really just game for doing whatever we needed to do, and as these shoots go, you always end up adding exercises, and Chris was totally cool with everything.
Why would fans want to buy the Men's Fitness with Chris Jericho on it? It's pretty much self-explanatory because Chris Jericho is on the cover. And there's photos of Chris Jericho inside, and there's a Chris Jericho pinup. It'll be like when a new Star Wars movie comes out. There'll be lineups at newsstands all across the world waiting for the new Men's Fitness to come out just to see my gorgeous mug on the cover of it. And why shouldn't they?